Good morning. I am Mohit Chadha and I am the HR manager of Sunshine College, and I am here for over 10 years of job, and I am here for your induction and orientation. As I have introduced you, and I also know that you are a new employee to our organization and you have been 2 years experience at another college. So I think that we shall start now. I am here for your induction program, and you will here get to know about your job assigned and also about the organization, how it works, what is its nature, and what kind of jobs you may have to perform rather than just teaching. And also, you will get to know about the history of our college so that you will feel that you are also a partner of our college, not just an employee. And so, we do this to make the employees motivated. And also, it helps them to feel connected with our college. So, you are assigned at job of Associate Professor of Economics. You have come here and you are assigned with among the 200 employees, and you are the, I think that you will be, may face some kind of difficulties. So you must go to the supervisor and tell HOD so he can resolve your problems.
Background.
Look better. And now I am going to tell you about Sunshine College. Sunshine College is established in 1990, and also it is now like just my family. They don't just this is not just a college offering education to the students, but also they make good human beings. Sunshine College, as I have told you, that established in 1990, and it was inaugurated by Stephen Hawking himself. So it is not just a minor college; it holds the, it has a great beneath of scientists, and also there are the graduates from our college were designated at higher positions in different companies, which are now known as the top companies of the world. And along with that, you are going to teach the students who are brilliant in their field and also come here from their from a bill after clearing the brilliant academics at that time. The motto of our college is to provide students world-class education here, not just do the formality of providing education, but to make them gain the experience of real life. And also they have, and when they graduate, they have that much power and that much so that they can establish their own business, their own field, and they can graduate as the profession, not just the theoretical ones. So we have mainly focused on the practical ones. Along with that, 30% of our education depends on the theory. So it is not just we can say on practical one or no, we cannot say that this is only the theoretical one. It depends on course to course, which the students hopes, but we feel that we can provide the n number of services, and along with that we focus on providing the world-class education and world-class experiences to them. And also the primary motive of our college is to make our college a brand. This means that we are going to establish our college as a world-renowned, not just to doing the formality of teaching students and just giving them the degree, and they just graduated and do not know about what they did, but from what they graduated. So this is the main motive, because if the person has got graduated from our college this and got a great job, so that will not also a privilege to him, but also feels or that our student goes to the higher ranks of the companies. And so the next slide. So now I'm going to tell you about the infrastructure of our college. Our college is nestled in the lap of nature and have the area of near about 4 to 5 square kilometer, which is not a lesser one. And also we renew our buildings and also the playgrounds every 4 years, so that students and teachers work in a healthy and safe environment. So that they do not feel any kind of difficulties in learning new things. And the next slide. Sunshine College has different departments and buildings for different subjects. This means that we have a different building and different department of just like the medical sciences, the engineering one. We have, as you know, that we offer every kind of education and as humanities, engineering, doctorate degree. This is named just as a college, but we work as we are the university one. So this, as you know, that I'm the HR manager, so also I have to manage those staff from the top authorities to a minor employee one. It is my responsibility to make them know what kind of education we are providing here. Along with this, there is a football ground, cricket ground, badminton court, tennis court, which are available for the students and the teachers all up throughout the year. They never kept closed, and you just have to make your student ID cards in the sports club so that you can get entry at any time. And after that, we have also teams of our college, that as you know that we have the football ground. We also have a football team of ourselves, which, and also the last year we got gold award in the state college championship. And also in badminton hall, we have organized an meeting with the LinkedIn 2 years ago, which is the world renowned badminton player, and also he was once at the top ranking of the world. So they came here and motivated people so that people will get encouraged not only to the education but also to the sports one, because some students get encouraged to the sports then to the higher amount, and they left out their studies, which is not a good one. So we organized organized a seminar with LinkedIn so that they encourage people to get encouraged in sports and also to the education. The founder of our college, Mr. Jacob Rose, he's the PhD in accountancy, and along with that, he's the member of the Welfare Society of Teachers in Victoria. He was so much encouraged to teach people, students, and also he's one of the best person I have ever met. He's a good human being, along with the not just my mentor, but also he's a very good human being. I learned a lot of things from them, and also I'm sure that you will also learn many many things from him. And he's very helpful. He always come to meet teachers every month, and also to give some kind of information regarding the new legislation and rules and news when there is changes made in the syllabus. He came himself to tell us about that. No doubt he sent us email, but he came here because he thought that he's going to encourage. This makes us motivated and also feel us as a partner one. So I think that we should go to the next slide. As I was told that our college is nestled in the nap of nature, and you can see the greenery all around our college. Here you will get that much motivated that you will never feel tired of working here, and also you feel energetic and enthusiastic to teach students. So we have taken this kind of place because when a person sees greenery around it, he feels motivated and fresh all the time. He never feels tired and we can say boredom of the work. And employees and students motivated, energetic, and employees has to work here from 9 to 5 p.m. This is your working hours, which you are going to work here, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. You have to work here and you have to be punctual. You must come at the 8:55, because whenever you get late, you have to pay fines, and if you don't pay fine, you are going to be absent in the attendance list. As we have the biometric system of attendance, so we cannot do any kind of plagiarism, and we can say the corruption in that. So I think next slide. Performance appraisal. Me, myself, the HR manager, perform the job of performance appraisal and performance management, and we measure the employees' performance on the monthly basis. And HR department does this job and it includes attendance, your performance, your rise in the student's capabilities, etc. The performance appraisal is just not focused on the attendance, not focused particularly on student capabilities based, and not just on your performance. It is a whole collaboration of all these things, because we cannot give focus on just one thing, because there are many other components of your performance appraisal. And if we found that you are very much good in your work, then we are going to appraise your position that we have, as we give promotion to our employees every 2 years, and we give increment to them of near about 10% every year. And if we get very much impressed from him or her, we also promote him in just one or one and a half year. We don't get that we have to clear our 2 years or 3 years to just promote him, but just seeing him and his capability, we promote him as per his capabilities. Next slide. The expectation. This means that what kind of things our organization expect from our employees. First of all, we expect that our employee to show honesty to us. We don't want that our employee is going to make false statements and make excuses of the work he made. And if any kind of criminal records, if he had in the past experience, then he must tell us about that at the time of recruitment. And we expect our employee to be honest to everyone, not just to the authorities, but to the students also. He must give the statement true and also make false statement. The other thing we expect is that you should do the smart work. This is the era of smart work, not just only the hard work. This is the collaboration of hard work along with the smart work. As you know that this is the era of technology, we expect our students to use projectors, laptops, and some kind of assignments that has real life experience. So to give them a real life experience and industrial experience, we thought that the smart work will be a better one. We expect our employees to do every possible effort to give them the real life experience. The next thing which we expect from our employees is the punctuality. If the meeting is going to be at 1 p.m., then we expect our employees to be there at 12:50. We don't want that anyone is coming in between the meeting or just 1 minute late. We cannot expect that. The next thing which we expect is the accountability and responsibility. If the HOD delegates you some kind of work, then you are accountable to it and also responsible to perform it at the time. If anything happens, then you must give the true excuse and not the false statement you made. If you have made a mistake, then just get in the mind of your HOD and anyone who delegated you the work. As if the wrong thing has been made, then it will get you in the wrong place and make you the seed of the problem. The next thing which we expect from our employees is the reliability, which means that we expect our employees to tell us the truth, what happened and what is going to happen as per the job assigned to them. If there is something problem they are facing, then and some kind of problems related to their co-workers and related to anything at the workplace, then we expect them to be reliable to us and have their trust in us. And anything which makes you the not a reliable one, then just tell me and the HOD. And if anyone is being unethical to you, the next thing which we expect is the ethical one. If anyone is unethical to you, just come to me and make a complaint of it, and just mail me or you can mail the HOD. No kind of unethical complaint and no kind of unethical behavior is expected among our employees, because being ethical is our primal motive. If anyone is the unethical one, then he is not going to promote himself, but also he may hinder the college goodwill. Along with that, he may give bias to the students also, which will not just destroy their future, but also it hampers the college goodwill also. And Now this is the end of your induction program, and now I'm going to show you the campus of our college along and the departments and the faculty room. So I think that you should come in. Now I'm going to show you the campus of our college. So first of all, I'm showing you the canteen area, or you can say the cafeteria. You can see here underneath that this is our cafeteria where all the students and the teachers can get their refreshments and eat the lunch and breakfast here. And there is also the optimum capability of having seats. There are almost 100 seats available for the students and the teachers. And here we offer a good quality of foods, and also a very superior one, not just a, just you can say to inferior, but you can get a quality food in just a little amount. Now I'm showing you the faculty room of our college. Now this is our the dining room of our for our teachers. Here the teachers come and eat their lunch and their breakfast, and also there is also the place for hand wash and for the drinking water. Here they can get the cold and the normal water to drink. And along with that, we have the washroom of the teacher behind there. And also, this must kept the hygienic to the premium level. And we have taken care of this from our heart, as just a little bacteria can cause harm to the not only to the teachers but also to the students. So we keep this area clean, and here you can see that no student has access to this. Only the teachers can access to this dining room. So now I'm going to show you the other area of our college. Now I'm going to show some of our classrooms of our college, and they are made with keeping in design so that we can show them the PPTs and some kind of motivational videos in the classroom also. As you can see that there is a projector installed here in every classroom so that we can give them lectures on the PPTs and online sessions we can take with universities, professors, and also with the scientists. And as I have told you in the induction program that we are mainly focused on the technological era, and so that our students after graduating can compete in this world very finely and not just graduate by just degree and scores, but they must gain the knowledge which is going to help them in their future life. Now I'm going to show you the faculty room. Now I'm going to show you the faculty room of our college. Here you are going to have your cabin at that corner, and you're actually can see you can see the HOD at the outer month. He has an separate cabin. Here the associates have their cabins. Along with that, you can see that they have their files and laptops available here. And also we make them available of printer and the telephonic call so that they can communicate to the any kind of lab and any area if there was an emergency. And you must come here after your attendance so that you have a priority to-do list at here pasted here, so that you can know that what jobs are you going to perform in your present day. So now I'm going to show you the library of our college. This is the library area of our college. Here you can get the daily newspaper of the various kinds of companies, just like the Times of India, the Fortune, the Tribune, and the Financial Express. And this is the area where the magazines are available of every kind. As you can see that the business magazines, the financial magazines, the economical magazines, and also the current affair magazines you can see here, and also some kind of the dictionaries are also provided here for the students which may find some difficult words in learning. And this is the area where you can get access to the every book of every subject. We have provided all kind of books to the limited edition one also, and we make sure that these books are remain in the first class condition and not get inferior one, so that the students which take book from here and learn from the thing, he must get a good knowledge and also The first hand information must be provided to him. Along with that, sample papers are also provided of the examination. Here you can see that the marketing management books are provided here. Along with that, the financial management one also. And we have assessed also to the law books also, which contains the legislations, rules and regulations, and some acts of the constitution. Here you can see the services of marketing, the internet of the this is the IT program, and also some kind of the business statistics books are also provided here. The security analysis, the humanities books, business law for management also provided here. And also the organizational behavior is also provided here. This is the complete blend of different kind of knowledge, and this is the area where students get to sit and learn new things from the book. Here they can get access to the seats, and also they can use the computers also if they want to use the internet. They also have the access to them. But he have to talk to the teacher first and get his permission before his or her permission before getting access to the internet. And this is also this video contains the reference books to the different subjects, and here you can get access only after getting permission to the teacher. And this is the this these two areas have access to the novels, and one of our teacher also wrote novel of his own, and it is one of the best novel I have ever read in my life. And so I must suggest you to read that also. And you can get access to this anyone, but the primary rule, as you know, of the library is to keep silent everywhere, and you must not make noise of any kind. This almirah contains the dictionary and this almirah contains books related to our history, and also regional books are also provided here, so that students coming from different community can learn their own community, and also they must learn another community's culture, and that this will help in their future. And they must get encouraged to learn new things and new cultures, as this makes them the enthusiastic and the energetic one. This almirah contains all the information technologies subjects, just like the Java, the C, the C++ language. Here they can get access to this in every second. And this contains the books donated by the peoples who encouraged and also have some privilege to donate books to the students. And we make ensure that every person who want to donate must have their names and their personal numbers written on these books, just like this, so that they must be known for their work, for their social work. And this is the almirah where all the microeconomics books are kept, so that you can get access to this. Now I'm going to show you the seminar hall of our college.
Three.
This is the seminar hall of our college. Okay. This is the seminar hall of our college, where whenever we organize a seminar, we use this room only, and any student, no employee has direct access to this. They must have a permission to get it, to enter this room. As I have told you in the induction program, we invited Mr. Lin Dan, the badminton player, 2 years ago. We invited him and get an autograph at the board there. And we also have their picture with our founder at that point. And also, this is a privileged room. This has the shadow of many renowned persons, the Stephen Hawking, the Jacob Rees, and also the people which have the huge name and fame in the real world. So I think that this is the end of our induction program. Here you can see beside me that this is the main entrance of our college, and you can get your attendance at that point. The biometric system is installed there. You firstly come here at 8:55 p.m. sharp and get your attendance done at the system, and after that you must go to the faculty room and take your to-do list, so that you must be remember of what kind of things are you going to do. So I think that you may come to the next day and have joined us as an associate professor of economics. Thank you.